Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Hi folks, welcome to 2025 and Happy New Year. I wanted to start this new year by making a video which gives a kind of a landscape view of what all the various different kinds of skills that one has to master to become a native Android developer. If I want to make a mental map of what are all different things that one needs to be aware of to say that I have some basic understanding of native Android development, then what all things that typically come under that. So that is the intention of this particular video. So if you have gone through this video, it will give a very good sense of where you are and what all things that you might have to cover. So without much further ado, let's get started. So if you take native Android development, first thing probably that you may have to start is learning the Kotlin fundamentals. But once again, this is very optional. If you want to do native Android development using Java, it is perfectly fine. Android supports Java-based development, but nowadays they have done major pivot towards Kotlin. And of course, there are certain advantages with Kotlin. That is the reason why this has happened. If you want to understand why Kotlin was chosen as preferred programming language much later for Android development, I suggest you can go through one of the videos. But under Kotlin fundamentals, what all things that you need to master? So first thing is probably you need to understand object-oriented programming concepts using Kotlin, and under that, you need to have a clear understanding of classes and objects, and then you should try to get a sense of how various things that are usually considered as part of object-oriented programming is done in Kotlin, like constructors, setters and getters, how to write functions, abstract classes, interfaces, access specifiers. There is a concept of data classes, object expressions, companion objects, and nested and inner classes. So that will give you a very good understanding of object-oriented programming in Kotlin. And other than that, of course, there are usual things like control flows in Kotlin, if else, when, which is like a switch in Kotlin, and various loops. The loops slightly look different in the way they are written in Kotlin. They are not your typical for loops. There are things like until, down to, range to, the way you step through the loops. And then the very important feature of Kotlin is null safety. So the optional character question mark comes into picture, which reduces a lot of templatized code that you might have written in Java that gets nullified because of null safety built into language as a feature. And then you should understand how the variables are declared, how the constants are declared, how the strings are worked with. All that is done, and after that you can move to some of the other concepts like lambdas, collections, and under collections you can work with three basic collection types: list, set, and map. And then there are various operations with the collections that you typically deal with: iterations, transformations, how to flatten a list or a collection, how to filter, group by. These are the typical operations that you do on a collection. And then, of course, coroutines, which is Kotlin's way of supporting multi-threading. So you need to understand how the coroutine is slightly different from threads, how the looper and handler concept works, multi-threaded coroutines, what is a launch and what is a sync. So if you have had a detailed understanding of all these things, then you are pretty much well set for the next things that are going to come, which is actual Android development. And under native Android development, there are various things that you probably have to concentrate on. So what I have done is I have decided to split into various things like UI, non-UI, broadcast receiver. So let's get started with something very basic, which is UI development. And under UI development, you need to understand how to create UI layouts. The UI layout of the application is created using XML format, and you basically inflate it in a component called as activity. Activity is one of the very important component in Android development. Think of it like a screen that you see on your Android app. And then fragments are like subunits of the activity. And all these can be designed using the XML based layout. And then much later, the concept of composables came into picture. Composable uses functional oriented programming, and using that also you can pretty much do the same thing. So that is where you learn these frameworks like Jetpack Compose, Jetpack Navigation, State Management, Side Effects, how to theme a application to create shapes, colors and typography, scaffold, how to create layouts using constraints, barriers and chains, and under constraints there are things like guidelines. And regardless of whether you use these two, you always work with how to manage the UI state management and how to handle the screen orientation change. So that is something that you will have to learn as a part of the UI development. And once that is done, there is another important concept called as intents. Intents is a mechanism where you connect various components of the Android application, like activity is one component, then you will see another component called broadcast receiver or a service. So intent is a way of triggering something in Android development landscape. So you will have to understand various ways of using the intents, using the concept of explicit intents, implicit intents, pending intents. There is a thing called broadcast receiver, which is like a listener. If you want to react to something that is happening in a mobile application, you typically use the broadcast receiver. With broadcast receiver, you always work with notifications. There are in-device notifications, there are ongoing notifications, and then there are push notifications. And to do a push notification, you need to also have an understanding of how the Firebase cloud messaging works, because you will be using the Firebase cloud messaging infrastructure to trigger the notification and handle it through using a broadcast receiver. And then you will have to do a drill down of how the data management is done. In Android, there are concepts like shared preferences, files, how to write a file, how to read from a file. Then there is a SQLite database. There is a wrapper on top of a SQLite database, which is called as room database. Then there is a content provider, which is one of the important component of Android application development. And it is through the content provider that two applications can share data between themselves. And for that, you need to have a very good understanding of how this content provider works with the custom content provider definition. And then probably most important thing is REST API integration. There are frameworks like OpenHTTP, Wally and Retrofit, which are most commonly used. And once this is done, you have a pretty good grasp of how to do the data management. Then you can move on to some of the advanced topics like mobile architectures. Some of the standard mobile architectures in Android are MVC, MVP and MVVM, that is Mobile View Controller, Mobile View Provider and Mobile View View Model. There is a kind of interrelationship between how these various architectures have evolved over a period of time. And then you have solid principles, which you need to really master if you want to write a good quality code. So then once you understand solid principles, you probably will be able to write a better code using dependency injection. You should understand what is dependency injection, how to do a manual dependency injection, and then later probably understand how some of the popular dependency injection frameworks work. Dagger, Hilt, Coin and Codein are some of the most popular ones. And then you should have the understanding of working with view model. View model is typically mainly used with MVVM design pattern. And then you have to understand the non-UI component based development. There are things like threading, handler and looper, services and intent services, bound services, local binding, remote binding, AIDL, work manager, work chaining, what is a job service, job scheduler, what is a async task. Async task is not used that much anymore in native Android development. Most of the other things are still very much in use in native Android development. And then of course you need to understand how to work with location awareness in Android application. So you need to understand how to fetch the location, how to fetch the address based on the location, which is called as geocoding, and how to fetch the location based on the address, which is called as reverse geocoding. And then there is geofencing. Those are the concepts that you typically learn as a part of the building location-aware apps. And then permissions are very important concepts in Android. So it is very, very important that you have a detailed understanding of how permissions work, what are dangerous permissions, what are normal permissions, how permissions are grouped together, how to handle the permission grants and rejections in a graceful manner so that the user, end user, is aware of what permission he is giving to the application and for what purpose. And you don't subvert the user choice by asking for some permission and doing something else. So this is a very bare minimum understanding of Android development that you may have to master as far as native Android development is concerned. So if you cover this, you are pretty much well covered in native Android development. So I think with this, you have now a pretty good mental map of what all things that you need to concentrate on, and also have a detailed understanding of where you stand in this whole network of skills that you typically associate with Android development. And another important thing to note is on CodeTutor, I have videos on almost all of these topics. Some of the topics are covered in Java, but now since last 1.5 years, most of the content is being delivered in Kotlin. You should be able to basically learn these concepts either in Kotlin, either in Java, or if you know Java, you should be able to migrate your code pretty easily to Kotlin. The course content is quite exhaustive. I have been putting these videos for now almost 10 years. The first video on CodeTutor dropped on, if I'm not wrong, 2014. And now we completed almost 10 years and there are more than 400 videos on our channel. And that's more than one video per day. It will still take more than 1 year to complete, go through the whole channel content. So anybody who is interested in learning Android development, not just how to, but why certain things are done in a particular way, then please do check out the content on the channel. Please go through the videos, playlists. I'm pretty sure you will find something that might be of interest to you. Needless to say, I am still uploading the videos. I will continue to be uploading the videos. Make sure that you have subscribed to get notified about whatever the new topics that I will be making videos on. So thanks for your time. Take care. And once again, happy new year.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.